So, dear friends, I hope you are rich enough, rich beyond any expectations, that once when you've been born, you are urging to get bigger in your financial endeavors. With 5 years of age, you start doing a small business selling lemonade on the street. Or not. Are you just sucking your thumb and waiting for your mommy to get you some, I don't know, milk? Did you breastfeed until age of 7, 9? Or you just continue abusing the nature without even taking responsibility as a little baby of 3 years of age to start doing your first business endeavor? Title: Could You Become Greedy Again With All This Bitcoin Hype? So what babies have to do with the Bitcoin? Exactly. Everything. Because Bitcoin becomes now a teenager. Goes in its, let's say, 10th year of existence, and he has to become more responsible. What is going to do? How is going to behave? Who's going to take care of all its, let's say, failures that Bitcoin did in the first 10 years of growth when he was just an infant? Yet nobody knows. Nobody knows what and how you become truly a Bitcoin millionaire, or maybe a billionaire. Where is all this 15 million Bitcoins are placed? Where they're located? Which accounts? I mean, you can find the accounts, but you really don't know where they sit. That's the biggest mystery for our lovely Feds, bankers, the Federal Reserves, central banks. They have no clue how to get to the point, how to actually try to capture these millions and millions of Bitcoins that now suddenly have a value. Until they were like 20 cents, dollar, $20, let's $200. He was, let's say, okay. Nobody paid too much attention. But now when it's $20,000, each Bitcoin, and it's just going to explode. I'm talking in February, end of February 2018. So wait for, let's say, end of March, beginning of April, such a beautiful hype. Yet it's not about enticing you to become really a Bitcoin millionaire. This conversation is about, are you still greedy as you've been with the euros or rands or US dollars? Or you just switched from US dollars into the Bitcoin or Satoshi at least? What if I tell you that in a matter of, let's say, less than a year, a 1 million Satoshis, which is just 1/100 of one Bitcoin, will be worth about $200,000. Reason why is because this is like a poop scooper of all the old fiat dollars, rands, yens, euros, and will just be sucked into a Bitcoin or one Satoshi. And it goes in, and suddenly the value of the Satoshi rise. Reason why: the value can only rise, not a volume, because volume is prefixed. Volume now developing his, let's say, teenage pimples, mood swings. As you can see in last couple of months, the Bitcoin dropped from $20,000 to $6,000. At the present time, back again to 12,000. So who cares? I mean, who really cares how much value the Bitcoin has, because you're not greedy. You just want to have enough to live comfortably, to share information with others, and becoming really a genuine person who cares for everything else but its own little needs. Do you need more that you have? Let's say, do you need more bitcoins that you have? That's a tough question. Do you need more euros and dollars that you have at the present time? Yes, of course you do. Because with these values or these currencies, you have to pay your bills, your medical bills, your rental bills, your, let's say, dying bills, and your church donations as well. When you reach the point, or when we as a so-called civilization reach the point where church start accepting bitcoins as a donation, then we know the church is dead. They are not there for any kind of spiritual enlightenment, any kind of, you know, spiritual support, or even material support. They're just there for their own selfish greeds. They are not too aware really what and how they can overcome this problem. Suddenly dollar is worth less and less, and Bitcoin is worth more and more. So there are, I mean, I'm kind of feeling these meetings, and I'm kind of sometimes spying on what they're talking about. They want to open a Bitcoin account for Vatican Church so you can do a donations. Can you imagine? Can you just imagine the stupidity of these organizations or whatever the entity that sits, one head in Vatican, another one in London, another one in Zagreb, another one in Washington, D.C. It's not an octopus. Octopus has one eye and eight tentacles. It's more like eight-headed snake that has like one body and eight necks with eight very, very greedy heads. So the teachings were very, very deceiving. We had been deceived as a humanity to pay attention only on our needs, how much we need. And if they tell us that we need more, we'll behave like this exactly as we've been told. So being greedy is not only a disease, it's an absolute pestilence for a human spirit. Because human spirit is not greedy at all. But human mental bodies, human emotional bodies are nothing else but greedy little pricks who doesn't want to change their attitude. Even if the body is dying, even if the situations are dire around this human who's supposed to be like carrying its soul within the body. And the greedy is the one who's mostly responsible for spirit to leave this body. It goes in fractions, like as much as you're greedy, you have less and less soul, or you have less and less spirit. So how to balance this back into very peaceful environment, so whatever you have, that you always satisfied. Honestly, we're playing a trick. I'm talking about creation, lightship, and all the beings who are well aware why we're playing this game with the Bitcoin. Many people are like, true in this world, more caring about who is the Satoshi rather than why this beautiful program or process or platform has been introduced to humanity. To learn not to be greedy anymore. To learn not to be nosy anymore. Who cares who Satoshi is? Care more about your greed and about your possessiveness, about your ownerships and properties. Who would say that suddenly millions of Bitcoins will show up and it will be distributed to the proper, let's say, programs and platforms. They're really supporting a good idea of equality, of sharing with every single one who's in need. And I tell you, materially, everybody is in need to have a decent life, to have a compassion in their heart for the next one, not to be competitive, not to be argumentative, because it's all about, like how people has been trained, it was all about who has more money for their own little needs. Now, who has more bitcoins? Creation Lightship. So when the time comes, you will be just quite surprised that platforms like Filecoin, ManaCoin, VaultCoin, these are the platforms that they will be absolutely supported with Satoshi's idea about equal distribution among every single human. And the greedy ones who were stealing, even now, at the present time, they try to steal in thousands of little Satoshis from accounts, and the people that really want to engage in this beautiful idea of Nakamoto Satoshi. So how to really help these greedy ones? My suggestion is wipe them clean of all these fiat dollars, fiat yens, fiat euros, or fiat rands. As if you check on my blog, I'm start posting it more and more about these big absolute failures of this old fiat system. Steinhoff Corporation Investment, whatever trust fund, lost $67 billion in a capital gains. Carillion, one of the biggest builders and manufacturers related with building the government properties like hospitals, like government buildings, and specializing, especially in Canada, was the second one. It's a British origin, but it was in Canada owning about maybe 40% of all this Canadian governmental buildings. And I have first-hand experience with these really freaks. Now, they're a junk. They're junk stock. They went from 260 pounds to 14 pounds, as I checked last week, in, let's say, value. Capital losses within the last year, and just on the original company of the Carillion, it's 138 billion pounds. It is staggering amount of dollars. You can actually support country after country after country. So where this money goes? Who owns this debt? They're trying now to play the game, blame game, towards the people of Britain, people of Canada, and they wanna, because they borrowed against the pension funds of all of these two countries, that's as I'm aware, but there are probably some other ones hidden within the structure of these funds, and they were actually owing 3 billion pounds towards the pension funds. So who's going to pay it? Now they're claiming the taxpayers will. Canadian taxpayer or British taxpayer? And I say no. They, the biggest investors, the owners, the executors, the executives will be the ones who are actually this time hit the road and take all the blame. Steinhoff is one of the, let's say, South African big financial firms. They were owning, I mean, they are still owning many of the stocks, food distributors, the furniture, and all the other retail shops, the malls. Yet the main guy, Christoph Ollen Wiese, is nowhere to be found, hiding in the biggest, you know, hole that he could dig. South African ex-president Zuma is charged for 783 criminal charges, now has no immunity anymore, having really a trouble to sign a deal to do the truth and reconciliation kind of type of deal with the government like DOJ of South Africa, not to be too long in the jail. He becomes a state witness, or anyway, he tries. By this, he started exposing the Gupta brothers, who were actually ruling Africa here, India, and many other countries that were not into the, let's say, Western media exposure. So when you tell me this greed, is this really a disease, or is this just a normal way of behavior? So if you see that this Christoph Ollen Wiese behaves like this, or Bill Gates, or whoever, Soros, or Warren Buffett behaves absolutely greedy, do you have to be the same? And do you have to wait for them to tell you what is important for you? When they say, now you can invest in a Bitcoin, they will not tell you, because they cannot touch any of these huge amount of really true value of the Bitcoin, which is in millions, will be distributed to a real humanistic funds or platforms. So check ManaCoin as one of, really, one of my favorites, with the idea what is hiding behind. This is universal basic income distributed through every single border, through every single nation. So you don't need a passport, you don't need any kind of proof, except that you are a human. And you deserve to be treated as one.